Let's look at the first floor plan now. And to start with, in your visibility and graphics, turn on your floors so they're visible, and then draw a detail line around the rear porch and the front porch right here. Okay, and those would be detail lines. Then turn your floors back off. Okay, we'll get into visibility graphics later, but it's kind of the same as the basement. No floors, no site work. Eventually, you're going to turn off reference planes. We don't have any plan regions in here, like we did, in the basement with the beam. So we don't have anything in here for that. So we'll deal with those later. Window tags, I talked about in the last video, and you can see I got them all placed in. I drug them out a little bit closer to the window and then adjusted my dimension lines out. Okay. Those should all be good. The door tags, I talked about that in the basement videos. And like I said, here at the front door, you'll end up with two tags, in which one of them for the which is the door panel, you can delete or hide, be okay. Dimensioning, all of your dimensioning should be face of core. If you haven't figured out yet, we're dealing everything face of core, and skipping the interior wall widths, with the exception of right here on this kitchen wall where it pulls it out at 3.5. Okay. Okay, room tags. Now, what I did is I created a new room tag. So I tagged one room and then come up here, went edit, duplicate, and I created two new ones. And I called one room tag 2-14 because that's my quarter inch scale. And I did one at 18, which is my 1/8 inch letter. Okay. And so I created them. I have to edit the family. Sorry. And on the label, excuse me, I added the City Blueprint quarter inch font and set it at bold when I brought that in there. And then I duplicated it and made another one that's an eighth inch. The eighth inch ones I'm using in the smaller rooms, as you can see here in the bath and the closets. Okay. You'll need to put in your room divider lines for, like the hallway between the dining room and the great room and across the kitchen here. So you just kind of finagle your way around there and then across the foyer there. So get all those in, tag your rooms, and then we'll hide the separation lines. So you can select one of them and then right-click Hide Category, and it'll get all of your room separation lines. Okay, we've got a sloped ceiling, so you can either dimension it or, that's probably the best way to draw it, is working off of the dimensions of the truss profile. Okay. And so we'll have this line going across, this line across here, and then this one across here at the hallway. And then we want to add a slope arrow, which is included in your files. And I did the quarter inch one since it has a larger arrowhead, and changed my suffix to be ceiling. Okay. So you want those two added in. Okay. In the files, I've given you an attic access panel. Now, to put this in, you'll need to be in a reflected ceiling plan. So you can, excuse me, open up your first floor reflected ceiling plan. And I placed one in this closet, and I went and placed one in the garage because a lot of times you would have one in the garage. It doesn't say anything on this plans, but a lot of municipalities want a fire barrier between the garage and the house, even up in the attic space. So, plus it just makes it a little bit better to easier to get around. So anyway, I put them in. You have to edit the size of it. And a lot of times this thing, if you put one in and then bring you a section view in so you can see it in section to make sure that it is up against the ceiling correctly. But you'll have to edit the size of it in edit type to get it to be the right size as it's shown on the prints there. Okay. Shelving, make sure you got shelving in all of your closets and that they're attached to the walls and not reversed. Okay. Let's see. At the garage, we need to add a step right here. And just, I made it whatever size it needs to be to come out past the casing there and bumped it up as tight as I could against the wall there. I'm not worried about tread nosings and those kinds of things on the garage step. Okay, appliances. I turned off labels on all of the appliances. You had to go into each and every one of them to turn it off. Just wondering why my oh, because I got the floors turned off. Okay. I may have to look at that and see what's going on with that right there, because my stair is showing up in the laundry room. I'll check my view range. Anyway, so I turned off labels on all the appliances, and then you can add a text label to it. Okay, so we're going to create a couple of floor plan callouts, and one is here for the kitchen. So I did one for the kitchen. And I did one around the bath vanities here. Okay. And I renamed those so I can find them easily in my browser over here. Bath call out one, kitchen call out one. And then what we're going to do is we're going to come in here and get this thing set up for our plan. And we're going to use a view template. It makes it easier on the other one. If we had multiple floor plans, we'd be doing a floor plan template, but we don't. I will get into view plan templates when we deal with elevations, because it just makes it so much easier to make those settings in one drawing and then have it copied over to all the other ones. But okay, so in this one, I set my scale at 3/8 inch, normal, fine. Visibility and graphics. The big things, I turned off floors, turned off plumbing fixtures. In casework, I turned off countertop and sink openings. And those, let's see, those are the main things that I wanted to turn off, okay, in dealing with my kitchen plan that I've got going here, okay. Now, before I turned off the countertops, I wanted to draw these lines for the overhang of the countertop before I turned it off. But then I turned it off, okay. And I think I'm going to turn off elevations also, once, because that's just so crowded. Yeah, I will. I'm gonna do it later though. Okay. So let me get back to my notes here. Okay, so cabinets. I want to tag my cabinets. And so you'll go annotate, tag by category, click on one of your cabinets, and it brings in the casework tag. Now I want you to edit family and duplicate that And when we're in families to duplicate it, you do a file save as, and I want to save it as a cabinet tag. Okay. And then I'm going to edit my label so that it's using mark. And the reason I'm using mark is because I can edit that in the properties over here. And all of them that are identical would have the same mark. Okay, so do that, load it into your project, and replace it on that particular cabinet. And then you can tag all of your cabinets. And you can see I named them B for base, and then whatever width the base cabinet is. This one is a drawer, it's a base drawer, 15 inches wide. This one is a sink base, 33 inches wide. Okay. And then for wall cabinets, I did a W, and then the width of the cabinet and the height of the cabinet. So this one's a W4830, W1530, 30 by 18, 15 by 30, 39 by 12. All right. And then did notes, leaders for the fillers. Got a filler there, filler there, fillers as needed by the sink, and then 1-inch fillers on this cabinet here. Note for the microwave there, end panel, dishwasher. I didn't put a note on a refrigerator yet. Probably could. I don't know. And then your finished dimensions. Okay. And that, all these notes. Okay, so that pretty much takes care of that kitchen call out. Now on the view template, let me flip my notes over here. What I did is I set everything up in this one drawing. So I set my scale, I set my mode. Let's see. Oh, there was some other things I needed to change too. I'm looking at my notes. So on casework, like I said, I turned off countertop and sink openings. I did a line override here on plan rep above and below, and I made it a solid line, but when you look at them, there's that one is solid. I guess that one would have worked, okay? I didn't even see that one when I started out. Oh, no override, solid, okay. Because what I want is a solid line for my cabinets in this particular view, in the call out. Turned off plumbing fixtures, we did that. Specialty equipment, I turned all of them off except for appliances. And I left that one on so that it picks up my refrigerator and those kinds of things. The microwave doesn't show because it's above the cut plane. I didn't want appliance hidden lines or the door swings on the appliances. Okay. All right. So on annotations, I turned off grids, references, sections, and I'm going to turn off elevations, because it's just too crowded in the kitchen there. And right now, I'm not going to do elevations drawings. That may change. I'm not going to say that's for sure, but that may change. All right, and it's okay on that. Okay, no underlay, of course. I set my view range. I've got it. First floor, 7'6", 4, and 0. So that works out quite okay. All right. So once you've got everything set for this, you can, you know, turn off. You may have to play with your crop region while you're putting in your annotations and stuff. And a lot of times it's leave that turned on, and you can even go, you know, do not crop view while you're getting in your dimensioning and texting or text. And then you can turn that back off and adjust it and then turn that one off. Okay. Now what I want to do is set up my view template. So I'll go view, view templates. And what you'll do is you'll go create template from current view. Now, I've already done that, so I'm not going to do it again, but you'll click that and you'll give it a name. And in this case, I called it kitchen cabinet plan. Okay. I've got the scale. So I did make changes to that. So you'll set it up here and give it a name. And then here's where you come back and edit something for everything that's assigned this view template. Okay. Did I have elevations turn off in this? Let me check it. Elevations off. Okay. And then these things over here, you can turn it on and off so that it would apply this to everything assigned this view template. Okay. So if you wanted to be able to have different view scales of different drawings or different views, you could not include that. And now you could set them individually. But I'm going to do that and leave it that. Okay. And then right here under view template in the browser, you're going to come back and pick that view template. All right. And now then title on sheet. I didn't put that in. What is this one called? Cabinet layout. Cabinet layout. Okay, and then once that's done, I'm putting it right here on my first floor plan drawing sheet. Okay, notes, we did this with just like in the basement with a legend. The wall bracing note is just two text boxes. Okay, now then, for the bath, let me open up. Where am I at? I'm at 17 minutes. Okay, let me stop here and then start another video.